Now that fifth graders have a couple of years of multiplication behind them, they can begin to understand it on a deeper level. This year, they'll learn to explain the difference between multiplying a number by a fraction and multiplying it by a whole number. Without actually doing the multiplication, your child should be able to tell you which will have a larger answer.
5 times 80 would be larger because the answer would be still bigger than 5 and 80. But a fourth times 80, it would be a fourth of 80, so it would be less than 80.
By the end of the year, fifth graders know that multiplying a whole number by a fraction less than 1 will always give you an answer smaller than the original whole number. And that multiplying 2 whole numbers will always give you an answer equal to or bigger than both of the starting numbers.
When you multiply these 2 numbers together, the number will be less than 20.
Okay. And what about 8 times 20? Would that be greater than 20 or less than 20?
Greater than 20.
So what can you tell me about when you multiply a whole number times a fraction?
It gives you a smaller number than the whole number you start with.
So how do you know your child's on track? By summertime, fifth graders can explain that multiplying a whole number by a fraction less than 1 always has an answer smaller than the original whole number. And that multiplying 2 whole numbers will always give you an answer equal to or bigger than both of the starting numbers.